That was appropriate edit, I thought, though. David Sockman's alive and well and with us, not on tape this morning, is right here. David, are you saying that what we've seen in the markets the past 3 days, and again this morning, is a reversal? All the markets are going down, and we're going to stay down. You saying that?
Yeah, I mean, people shouldn't be surprised. This was predictable. We have had essentially a lunatic monetary policy for the last 5 years. Remember, when Lehman happened in September 2008, it had taken 94 years to get the Fed's balance sheet to $900 billion. Today, it's $3.5 trillion almost. Bernanke has been flooding the system with money. It is but what I'm saying is it has caused massive inflation of financial assets, distortions, chasing for yield everywhere into risky asset markets around the world, EM, real estate, junk bonds, you name it. None of this was sustainable.
So is time up on all of this?
I think time is up. Exactly.
It is now. Now is the reversal.
It's inevitable that this massive bubble that's been inflated for 5 years of panicked monetary expansion and money printing will unwind, and it's going to take everything down with it over a period of time.
So this is all your fault. You come on this program and you say everything's going to go down and happen. Now, wait a second. There's another element in the news today, and that's China.
Right.
Their banks are shaky. Their central bank says, we're not going to print a ton of money to bail you out. What do you make of that?
Well, they've been printing a ton of money, just like all the other central banks of the world. In other words, this isn't uniquely a Fed problem. All the central banks of the world have been expanding their balance sheets. If you go back and look, you can see that in 2000, all the banks of the world, central banks, had $1 trillion of balance sheet combined. Today, it's $15 trillion. All of them have been printing money at this fantastic rate. We've created bubbles all over the world. China is the greatest bubble in human history. Even their new leadership recognizes that and is beginning to make tepid, tentative steps to try to rein it in, just as the Bernanke Fed finally realized it had to do last week. So I think this is a global adjustment. Look at in Japan. The great money printing spree they were going to have is already, hitting the rocks in many ways.
This is real doom and gloom, David.
Well, it's not necessarily doom and gloom. It's a...
But it's all markets down. Gold right. down, stocks way down all right. over the world.
Right.
And by the way, the yield on the 10-year Treasury gone up to 2.63%. Right. I know that's not very high, but it's a spike from what we've been at recently.
Last fall, it was 1.47. Okay, a 50% increase, or more than that, 66% increase in yield in a few months. That is not a sign of healthy free markets in the financial system. That is a sign of markets that are part of a casino that's been entirely dominated, fueled, manipulated by the Federal Reserve and the other banks of the world. It isn't sustainable. Sooner or later, the central banks lose control of the markets, and then you have chaotic adjustment. You have yo-yo markets. You wake up and find the stock market in China is down 5% overnight, or Japan is down 9% overnight.
What we like on this program is clarity.
Yeah,
you're very clear on what you've been saying. This is a gigantic bubble because of all this money printing, $15 trillion worth all the way around the world. And now the chickens have come home to roost. That is your analysis.
I think that's right. Now, a lot of people who come on the program are in the bubble. They believe in central bank, management of the economy. I call it central bank monetary central planning. Somehow, notwithstanding all of the bubbles that have collapsed in the last 15 years, dot-com, housing, the Wall Street Lehman Brothers bubble, now this one, somehow they continue to believe that their central bankers have their back, know what they're doing, and will make it all better. Okay. Sooner or later, investors are going to find out that was totally an illusion. It was a complete myth. They're on their own, and it's a dangerous world.
David Stockman, why don't you stay right there? Okay. We're going to get